Located on an old fortification which overlooks the harbor of Brest, this memorial commemorates the brilliant achievements of the American Navy. The official party arrives and passes in front of the sailors of the USS Kane, which was sent to Brest for the occasion. Admiral Nazine, the senior French naval officer at Brest, delivers an address.
Devant messieurs, le sénateur et député des États-Unis, et les hautes personnalités qui les accompagnent, je me bornerai à parler en marin et à évoquer le souvenir de nos frères d'armes, de nos amis de cette division américaine, de Brest, la fierté d'abriter pendant 2 ans.
Judge Finnis J. Garrett of the American Battle Monuments Commission makes the introductory address, the first part of which is a message from General Pershing, who was unable to attend.
It would be quite impossible for me, speaking in my former capacity as commanding general of the American Expeditionary Forces, to express adequately my appreciation and admiration for the heroic and unselfish contribution made by the Navy during the war. Of the 2 million American soldiers who crossed the ocean under the safeguard of the Navy, there is not one who has not many times, in the depths of his heart, thanked the Navy. We desire, in this particular and special way, on behalf of our government, to pay tribute to the services rendered by the Navy, that I present the Honorable Richard Russell, a United States Senator from the state of Georgia.
Judge Garrett, Mr. Ambassador, Admiral, Mr. Senator Mayor, ladies and gentlemen, we have just concluded a sacred pilgrimage as representatives of the government of the United States to dedicate the battle monuments our nation has erected in France. Each of them marks a spot where the heroism of American soldiers in battle added luster to the glory of our republic. We have stood in solemn silence in the chapels that are surrounded by the bright crosses, marking the last resting place of those who fell in the cause of liberty.
The monument is dedicated by Ambassador Josephus Daniel, the American wartime Secretary of the Navy and a member of the official delegation.
1781, the day, however, as we dedicate a memorial to the heroes of the American Navy, and likewise to the French, it is fitting to appraise the obligation America 1917 owed to France in the days of American Revolution. In his extremity, Washington felt the necessity of strong naval support and agreed with his French comrade Rochambeau, who wrote, "Nothing without naval supremacy." Washington displayed genius in declining to send American and French troops into the major attack until he could depend upon naval superiority. In our day, the toast of Lafayette, that the unity of the American Republic has saved us in our time of danger, and his prophecy, it will save the world.